Funny Cave.
The five dumbest criminals of all time. Number 5, a 37-year-old San Francisco man drove a stolen Lexus SUV to court on the day that he was about to be convicted for an unrelated auto theft charge. He ended up being charged with 2 auto thefts that day. Number 4, in July 2012, police got a call about a break-in at Central New Mexico Community College. When the police got there, they found a 38-year-old man tangled up in the window blinds. He was charged with burglary and breaking and entering. Now, a few thoughts about this. First of all, if you're a burglar and you can't get past window blinds, maybe you're not cut out to be a burglar. Maybe you should rethink your career choice. I mean, think about it. This guy was stopped by something that was there to prevent sunlight from getting in. This guy is like dumber than sunlight. If this guy and sunlight took an IQ test, sunlight would probably get the higher score. Tangled up in window blinds. This man's plans were thwarted by home decorations. This guy was stopped by something you can get for like $19.95 at IKEA, okay? He couldn't figure out how to get past some plastic and some thread, because that's what window blinds basically are, plastic and thread. Number 3, a West Virginia woman came home one day and found that 2 diamond rings were missing. She then noticed that her computer was logged into a Facebook account that she did not recognize. Police followed the trail to 19-year-old Jonathan G. Parker, who had apparently stopped to check his Facebook account while he was in the middle of a robbery and forgot to log out. Number 2, Jamie Neal and Gareth Tilly were drunk and high on stolen medication when they decided to rob a gas station in Cornwall, England. How did they get caught? Well, it might have something to do with the disguise that Jamie Neal had on. This is a still from the security camera. And as you can see, to hide his face, Jamie Neal put a see-through bag on his head. Because the best way to obscure your identity is with something that's see-through. Police soon arrested the 2 men, presumably after they were done laughing. Number 1. In January 2014, police in Daytona Beach, Florida, said a man entered a TD Bank and robbed it, but left the money behind. But what I want to know is it even a crime if you rob a bank and you leave the money behind? After all, you're not actually taking the money with you. The money is still at the bank. All you did was just move the money a little bit. I mean, if you go into Safeway and you grab a can of tuna off the tuna shelf and then you take it and you leave the tuna over by the breakfast foods, you're not going to get arrested for shoplifting, are you? All you did was move that can of tuna a couple of aisles over. The can of tuna is still in the Safeway. Not a crime. I mean, look, this isn't armed robbery. This is armed forgettery. But I don't know how you can forget money when you're robbing a bank. It's not like you have a million things to keep track of. After the bank teller gives you the money, the hard part's over. At that point, your job is pretty simple. You leave with the money. I know it's a pressure-filled situation, but still, this isn't brain surgery. Anyway, thanks for watching and leave your comments below. Or leave them above. I don't care. Bye for now.